Friends, multiplexer. The selection of a particular input line is controlled by a set of selection lines. Normally, there are 2 power n input lines and n selection lines whose bit combination determines which input is selected. So basically, what does a multiplexer do? If we are giving 2 power n input lines, then our output should be a particular input. So we are giving 2 power n input lines, means 2 power n different inputs we are giving, and we need a particular input as the output. So to select that particular input line, we are giving n selection lines, n selection inputs. So the bit combination of those n selection inputs will decide that which particular input line will be the output. So this is the meaning of multiplexer. So here in this case we are giving 2 inputs, I0, I1, and 1 selection input. So the bit combination of this 1 selection input will decide which of these 2 inputs will be the output. So I0, I1. So the subscript here determines or describes the decimal value. So here we are having only 1 selection input. So the bit combination of this 1 selection input can be 0 or 1. That's why here input subscript are 0 and 1. So I0 will be the output if this selection line gives it 0. Here I1, so S gives it 1. So what I'm basically trying to say that I0 will be the output when the bit combination of this selection line is 0. I1 will be the output when the bit combination of the selection line is 1. So this is already done in the circuit. This AND gate takes 2 inputs, I0 and the selection input, and here the selection input is negation. We are taking the inverted value of the select line input. So when we give the select line input as 1, so here it will go 0. So and if the selection line is 0, then here it will go as 1. So as we discussed, the bit combination of these selection lines will decide which particular input will be the output. So here the binary value of the bit combination of this select input will decide, or we will match this binary value with this decimal value. So if S is equals to 0, then its decimal equivalent is 0. So this input will be the output. If the bit combination of this S is 1, then its decimal equivalent is 1. So I1 will be the output. So if S is 0, so here it becomes 1. So here to this AND gate, this select input is giving as 1. So I0 will be the output. If I0 is 0, then output will be 0. If I0 is 1, then output will be 1. So if S is equals to 1, then to this AND gate we are giving 0. So this will be basically 0. So I0 will not be the output. This AND gate, this select input will be passing 1 to this AND gate. So I1 will be the output. So in this way, the bit combination of the select input decide which particular input is going to be our output. So how do we decide it? Take the bit combination of the select inputs, then convert that bit combination, take the binary value. So take the binary value of those bit combination. That binary value will be the minterm value of these subscripts. So we will take the example in which two select inputs are there. So this is here we are giving four inputs, I0, I1, I2, I3, and two select inputs, S0, S1. So here basically which of these four inputs is going to be output is decided by the bit combination of these two select inputs. So here these are the four bit combination of these two select inputs, so 0001 1011. So let's consider this 00. This is the bit combination of the select inputs. So this 00, now we will consider this binary value, its decimal equivalent is 0, so I0 will be the output. Now consider this bit combination 01, its decimal equivalent is 1. Why we are taking its decimal equivalent? Because this bit combination is the minterm value of 1. This bit combination 10 is the minterm value of 2. So consider these bit combination as the minterms. So the corresponding input with the same subscript will be the output of this whole circuit. So here we are giving four inputs, I0, I1, I2, I3, and the 4 is equivalent to 2 to the power 2, so 2 power n is equals to 2. So 2 select inputs we will give, S0 and S1. Now the bit combination of these two select inputs will decide which one of these four inputs will be our output. So the bit combination of these select inputs will be the minterm corresponding to the inputs. And how will be the I0 the output if the S0 and S1 is 00. So if S0 is 0, so this AND gate takes 0, so it becomes 0. Consider this AND gate, so here S1 goes directly, so this becomes 0. Take this AND gate, here again S0 goes as it is, so it becomes 0. And to this AND gate, both S0 and S1 gives their complemented value, so it goes 1 1. So S0 and S1 becomes 1. Now the output will be I0 itself. So basically here S0 complement of S0 and complement of S1 and I0. S0 and S1 are 0 0, so their complement will be 1 1. So S0 and S1 will be 1, and the final output of this AND gate will be 1 and I0, so output will be I0. So this is how the bit combination of these select inputs decide which one of the four input will be the output. So basically what does a multiplexer do? It takes 2 power n inputs and it gives one of those 2 power n inputs. It selects one of the particular input and it gives it as output. So if 2 power n input lines are there, then we will take n selection lines and select inputs. So the bit combination of those n select input will decide which of the 2 power n input is going to be the output. So this is the multiplexer. I hope you understand this. Thank you.